Gabriele Falloppio, Wikipedia audio. Gabriele Falloppio, often known by his Latin name Falloppius, was one of the most important anatomists and physicians of the 16th century. He was born in Medina and died in Padua. His family was noble but very poor, and it was only by a hard struggle he succeeded in obtaining an education. Financial difficulties led him to join the clergy, and in 1542, he became a canon at Medina's cathedral. He studied medicine at the University of Ferrara, at that time one of the best medical schools in Europe. He received his M.D. in 1548 under the guidance of Antonio Musa Bras Savola. After taking his degree, he worked at various medical schools and then became professor of anatomy at Ferrara, in 1548. Girolamo Fabrizi was one of his famous students. He was called the next year to the University of Pisa, then the most important university in Italy. In 1551, Falloppio was invited to occupy the chair of anatomy and surgery at the University of Padua. He also held the professorship of botany and was superintendent of the botanical gardens. Though he died when less than 40, he had made his mark on anatomy for all time. Falloppio's own work dealt mainly with the anatomy of the head. He added much to what was known before about the internal ear and described in detail the tympanum and its relations to the osseous ring in which it is situated. He also described minutely the circular and oval windows and their communication with the vestibule and cochlea. He was the first to point out the connection between the mastoid cells and the middle ear. His description of the lacrimal ducts in the eye was a marked advance on those of his predecessors, and he also gave a detailed account of the ethmoid bone and its cells in the nose. His contributions to the anatomy of the bones and muscles were very valuable. It was in myology particularly that he corrected Vesalius. He studied the reproductive organs in both sexes, and described the fallopian tube, which leads from the ovary to the uterus and now bears his name. Early life. The aqueductus Falloppii, the canal through which the facial nerve passes after leaving the auditory nerve, is also named after him. Falloppio's contributions to neuroanatomy, however, are still of interest today due to attempts to better understand the structures he first found. He was interested in the sensory systems in the face. He centered his research on understanding the path of the nerves of the face and structures that lie in their tracks. Here, he left his name to two parts of the human face, only emphasizing his enormous influence on the study of the head. The facial canal was first described by Falloppio, who studied its path, structure, and contents. He also described the fallopian hiatus, an opening in the anterosuperior part of the petrosal bone. His contributions to practical medicine were also important. He was the first to use an oral speculum for the diagnosis and treatment of diseases of the ear, and his writings on surgical subjects are still of interest. He published two treatises on ulcers and tumors, a treatise on surgery, and a commentary on Hippocrates's book on wounds of the head. In his own time, he was regarded as somewhat of an authority in the field of sexuality. Falloppio was the first to describe a condom, and he advocated the use of such sheaths to prevent syphilis. In an early example of a clinical trial, Falloppio reported that he tested these condoms in 1,100 men, none of whom contracted syphilis. Falloppio was also interested in every form of therapeutics. He wrote a treatise on baths and thermal waters, another on simple purgatives, and a third on the composition of drugs. None of these works, except his anatomy, were published during his lifetime. As we have them, they consist of manuscripts of his lectures and notes of his students. They were published by Walter Keuter. Falloppio argued against Fray Castro's theory of fossils, as described as follows in Charles Lyell's Principles of Geology. Falloppio of Padua conceived that petrified shells had been generated by fermentation in the spots where they were found, or that they had in some cases acquired their form from the tumultuous movements of terrestrial exhalations. Although a celebrated professor of anatomy, he taught that certain tusks of elephants dug up in his time at Puglia were mere earthy concretions, and, consistently with these principles, he even went so far as to consider it not improbable that the vases of Monte Testaccio at Rome were natural impressions stamped in the soil. This was the golden age of anatomy, and Falloppio's contemporaries included such great anatomists as Vesalius, Eustachius, and Rialdo Colombo. It has sometimes been asserted that he was jealous of certain of the great discoverers in anatomy, and that this is the reason for his frequent criticisms and corrections of their work. However, Heinrich Haeser, an authority in the history of medicine, declared that Falloppio was noted for his modesty and deference to his fellow workers, and especially to Vesalius. His purpose in suggesting corrections, therefore, was the advance of the science of anatomy. Medical contributions. Legacy. Works.